Om Swastiastu, good morning, Doctor. We are from Small Group Discussion B2. Today, we will present our student project with the title Prescribing Analgesic Antipyretic. Before we start our presentation, we will introduce ourselves. Next slide. Okay, the member's name and the student numbers can be seen on the slide. Okay, now we will start our presentation. Next slide. I will read the case that is given to our group. So the case is Ms. Ari, 25 years old. She has migraine with increasingly frequent vomiting. Paracetamol no longer effective during attacks. You explain to her that the paracetamol does not work because she vomits the drugs before it is solved. You prescribe paracetamol plus an antiemetic suppository, metoclopramide, which she should take first and wait 20 to 30 minutes before taking the paracetamol. Okay, that is the case. And for the next presentation, will be presented by Matt. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Sigiri Pramaditya Wahyusaputra and the last three digits of my student numbers are 045. In this occasion, I would like to present the problem and the therapeutic objective in this case. The first one is a problem. Based on the case given, there is a 25 years old woman named Ms. Ari who has migraine with increasingly frequent vomiting. Migraine is often characterized by unilateral headaches, commonly moderate to severe. Migraine is also often associated with nausea and vomiting. To overcome this problem, Ms. Ari should take antiemetic drugs, which is metoclopramide, through rectal and wait until the gastrointestinal motility is back normal again to use paracetamol to cure the migraine. By the combination of analgesic and antiemetic, there will be stimulation of gastric emptying, which is prokinetic and accelerates the absorption of paracetamol. The second one is therapeutic objective. There are 3 points of the therapeutic objectives for Ms. Ari, which are: the first one is to treat and cure her migraine. The second one is to treat and cure the vomiting effect from her migraine. And the third one is to make both treatment for her migraine and vomiting effective so that Ms. Ari is back healthy again. That's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, hello everyone. My name is Nilukade Asri Bintari with the last three digits of my student number is 063. Today, I would like to present about the description of pharmacokinetics. The first one is pharmacokinetics of metoclopramide. Absorption of metoclopramide from suppositories may vary between individuals due to several factors, such as the state of the rectum and the characteristic of the suppository preparation itself. Metoclopramide has a low-level attachment to plasma proteins. This means that most of the metoclopramide is in the free or unbound form in circulation, which allows it to diffuse into the target tissues. Administration of metoclopramide suppositories can prevent the drug from the first pass effect that occurs in the liver. Most of the dose of metoclopramide is excreted in urine and a small portion through feces. The next one is pharmacokinetics of paracetamol. Oral absorption of paracetamol is influenced by several factors such as gastric emptying rate, delayed by food, and increased by metoclopramide. Paracetamol is marginal to be bound to plasma proteins. Therefore, most of paracetamol levels are in the free or unbound form in circulation. In young adults, paracetamol is metabolized to paracetamol glucuronide and paracetamol sulfate as main metabolites. 5% of the dose is excreted as unchanged paracetamol in the urine and 5 to 10% is oxidized by cytochrome P450. That's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, I will continue the presentation. My name is Niputu Ariapsari with the last three digits of my student number as 058. I will talk about pharmacodynamic of metoclopramide. Metoclopramide is a dopamine 2 receptor antagonist which can affect many receptor systems in the wall of gastrointestinal tract, usually stimulated by levodopa or apomorphine. This is achieved by desensitizing visceral every nerve that travels from the gastrointestinal system to the vomiting center in the post-rema area of the chemoreceptor trigger zone. Next slide. And next, about pharmacodynamic of paracetamol. Paracetamol is currently marketed as an analgesic, also antipyretic, and should not be used for more than 3 days without consulting a doctor. Paracetamol is para-aminophenol derivative that exhibit analgesic and antipyretic effect, primarily by inhibiting prostaglandin synthesis in the central nervous system. The cyclooxygenase or CHOX enzyme has several isoforms. The best known are CHOX1 and CHOX2. That's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much for the change. My name is Deputangi Praditya Putri. My last 3 digit of my student number is 067. And today I'm going to present drug interaction as safety. So first, we have to know the definition of drug interaction. The drug interaction occurs when two or more medications interact, or when a drug interacts with meal, beverage, or supplement. It can alter the way medication function or induce undesirable side effect. In this case of Mr. Ari, he used to have the metoclopramide, paracetamol, and also suppository. The metoclopramide itself used as a drug that can combine with painkillers or analgesic, in this case is paracetamol. So it's safe for Mr. Ari to consume the metoclopramide and paracetamol. Other than that, suppository is used together with metoclopramide to make it easier for patients, in this case Mr. Ari, to digest the drug and facilitate absorption of the drug. So you may asking why Mr. Ari need to consume the paracetamol after 30 or 20 minutes. It's because the onset of metoclopramide itself range from 30 until 60 minutes at oral doses. So it will be better if paracetamol was used after metoclopramide reach onset. That's all my presentation for today. Let my friends be the next. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Dinaria Sakura Kirani and the last 3 digit of my student number is 055. I will present to you the efficacy of metoclopramide and paracetamol. Metoclopramide exists in several forms, including oral tablets and liquid. It could administer orally by subcutaneous injections, intravenous injections, and nasal spray. Compared to the oral form, the nasal spray shows a better symptoms control and less side effects. The efficacy of paracetamol has been tested in many conditions and capable of showing therapeutic efficacy in acute and chronic pain. Paracetamol is active as a single agent and synergistic with NSAID and opioids. In the fast dissolving formulations, paracetamol efficacy is intact. The next presentations will be continued by my partner. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Kadek Bintanista Putri, but my student digital master number is 056, and I'll explain about the suitability of dosage schedule. And the first one is the dosage schedule of metoclopramide. Metoclopramide is an antiemetic that given through rectal is the best way to soothe nausea, vomiting, and problems of swallowing. In emergency department, metoclopramide is also used to treat acute migraine. The rectal metoclopramide dosage schedule is at the onset of the attack. The dose of metoclopramide is 20 milligrams, one suppository, and the dosage should stop in within 5 days. The next one is dosage of paracetamol. The dosage of paracetamol of the oral tablet paracetamol is 4 until 6 times a day, every 4 until 6 hours. The dosage of paracetamol ranging from 500 milligrams to 1,000 milligrams, and reaching a maximum daily dose of 4,000 milligrams. This schedule is related to the side effects of paracetamol that could cause liver damage. In moderate patients weighing below 50 kilograms, there is a caution dose reduction to twice a day, 2 grams per 24 hour. When combined with metoclopramide, paracetamol might be taken 20 until 30 minutes after the administration of metoclopramide through rectal to wait till the gastrointestinal turn back into the normal function. That's all from me, and the next slide will be presented by my friend. Thank you.
Okay, I will continue. My name is Iputu Pranadea Fidesagara with the last 3 digits of my student number are 059. And now I will explain about the suitability of duration. For paracetamol, the duration of administration in adults is 10 days. Analgesic action of paracetamol occurs after 2 until 3 hours since the drug intake according to the duration, the therapeutic concentration needed for suppositories. In order to avoid medication overuse headache, the use of paracetamol is limited for 15 days per month. But if the paracetamol combined with other analgesics, the consumption duration must be no more than 10 days per month. Diabetic gastroparesis and GERD chronic that treated with offering metoclopramide orally, intravena, or intramuscular have a maximum duration of 12 weeks. But to treat nausea, vomiting, and gastric stasis, metoclopramide should not be consumed for more than 5 days. These rules apply for both adults and children. That's all for me. Thank you.
Okay, my name is Made Prema Pratnya Prasanti with the last three digits of my student number are 064. I will continue the presentation with determining of drug choice, drug dose, and dose regimen. So for the first is dose form and dose regimen of paracetamol. There is active substance, dose form, paracetamol, or acetaminophen, oral tablet, 500 milligram with dosage schedule, 2 tablets every 30 minutes after taking metoclopramide with the duration for adults. The maximal duration is 10 days. There is a note. In general, the adult dose of for paracetamol is 5 milligram to 1000 milligram every 4 to 6 hours with maximum daily dose of 4000 milligram. The second is dose form and dose regimen of metoclopramide with active substance. Dose form, metoclopramide suppository or rectal, 20 milligram with dosage schedule, 1 suppository per rectal at the onset of the attack. With the duration should not be consumed for more than 5 days to treat nausea and vomiting. Okay, that's all from me. And the next slide will be presented by my friend. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Nika Potomi Kainami and my last three number is 048, and today I will tell you about the prescription to Mrs. Ari. So in the top of the prescription, there's the identity of the doctor that includes the name of the doctor, SIT, the address, and also the telephone number. And there's also the date of making the prescription, which is the Denpasar, 26 May 2023. For the prescription, there's a superscription and insubscription, which is paracetamol 500 milligram, tab numero 10, and Cigna tab 2 PRN, which means the patient, which is Mrs. Ari, needs to take 2 tablets of paracetamol 500 milligrams if needed. And there's also, for the superscription, there's also metoclopramide 20 milligram soup, number 5, and Cigna soup 1 PRN vomit, which means the patient have to take 1 suppository metoclopramide 20 milligrams if needed to treat the vomit. At the bottom of the prescription, there's the name of the patient and also the age of the patient, which is 25 years old. Maybe that's all for me. The next slide will be presented by my friend.
Okay, hello everyone. My name is Putu Sangitani Rajanari, and the last three digits of my student number are 049. I'm here about to explain the evaluation or stop therapy of the cases that we got in our small group discussion. So the first one, therapy monitored for 5 days according to the duration of the drug. And if the symptom experienced by the patient is to not decrease, then the patient is advised to consult to the doctor. The second one, patient can continue therapy if the attack reappears as long as there is no side effect arise. And then, under certain condition, if any side effect appears, then therapy should be stopped and further consultation about alternative medicine is needed. And then the last one, if within 5 days the symptom experienced by the patient begin to decrease and the patient condition is approved, then the therapy can be stopped. That's all that I can say. The next slide will be presented by my friend. Thank you.
Hello, doctors and friends. My name is Tirza Fitania Amaris, and the last 3 digits of my student numbers are 060. and I will continue about the last part of the student project about communication, information, and education as a component patient medication safety. So the communication, information, and education that should be given to Ms. Eri is the first line treatment of migraine is NSAID like paracetamol, acetaminophen. The problem in Ms. Eri here is the paracetamol didn't give any reaction to the body. The frequent vomiting causes the paracetamol drug got absorbed slower and give less reaction. Because of this, before Ms. Eri take the paracetamol, the doctor also prescribed an antiemetic suppository, the metoclopramide. Metoclopramide should be given by oral 20 to 30 minutes before consuming by the paracetamol 3 times daily, with the maximum dose each day is 30 milligrams or 0.5 milligrams per kilogram body weight. After curing and reducing the frequency of vomit, then Ms. Arvi can consume the paracetamol by oral. The paracetamol should be consumed 4 to 6 times a day, every 4 to 6 hours, with the dose of each tablet is 500 to 1000 milligrams, until reaching the maximum daily dose of 5000 milligrams. That's the end of presentation from small group discussion with B2. We are sorry about the mistakes we've done in the video. And thank you for listening.
Okay, that's all from our presentation. Thank you for listening. We are sorry if there are mistakes during our presentation. We close this presentation with Paramasanti. Om Santi 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 Om.